In the last webcast, we found the heteroaromatic pyridinone was a byproduct of the substitution reaction that we looked at. And seeing that structure to pyridinone reminds me that we should always remember about tautomerization when we're talking about heteroaromatics, especially when we're looking at tautomers that have oxygen and nitrogen substituents on the aromatic ring. So 2-hydroxypyridine is the tautomer of 2-pyridinone, and I only showed you this structure. And it turns out that that's actually where the equilibrium lies. It lies to the side of 2-pyridinone. We can actually understand by taking into some consideration the different resonance contributors of these two molecules why it is that the tautomer 2-pyridinone is more favored than 2-hydroxypyridine. So let's take a look at the most important resonance contributors for each of these structures. For sure, for 2-hydroxypyridine, the most important resonance contributor is this neutral form, and that neutral form is aromatic. And we can draw a resonance contributor in which there is donation of the oxygen lone pair into the ring, but notice that we've got negative and positive charges in a reverse sense according to their electronegativities. Oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen. It would rather be the negatively charged species, and that's not the case for the second best resonance contributor of 2-hydroxypyridine. Take a look at pyridinone. In this case, the neutral molecule is there. It's actually not an aromatic ring system, but it turns out that it has a very important resonance contributor over here that is aromatic. And so we do see that 2-pyridinone does indeed have aromatic character in this resonance contributor. Not only that, it has the right charges. It has its most electronegative atom carrying the negative charge, and its least electronegative atom, nitrogen, carrying the positive charge. And so 2-pyridinone, the charges in the second best resonance contributor do match up, and that's really the reason why we favor the 2-pyridinone over the 2-hydroxypyridine. Now it's a little more complicated than that, and I'll just give you a hint which is important when we start talking about the base pairing through hydrogen bonds of nucleic acids. Look at how the 2-pyridinone is really very well set up with a hydrogen bond donor and a hydrogen bond acceptor for doing a hydrogen bond dimerization. This additional hydrogen bonding is really quite effective at stabilizing the dimer, and that dimer is a coupled equilibrium. This hydrogen bonding dimerization is a coupled equilibrium between the tautomerization and then the hydrogen bonding to make this dimer that helps to stabilize that tautomeric form. So go ahead and give the resonance contributors of each of these tautomers some consideration. Draw them out, draw the second best resonance contributor out, and you'll conclude in the case of the thione, the structure that's shown here, that this is the favored tautomeric form. You can see the equilibrium arrows lie to the right, and when we do consider the second best resonance contributor, we would again, in the case of thione, be putting the negative charge on sulfur and the positive charge on nitrogen, and this thiol pyridine has the charges reversed. So thione favors the tautomer that's shown on the right. What about the case of aminopyridine? Aminopyridine actually favors the tautomerization lying in the opposite direction. This ring, its best resonance contributor, is aromatic. And if we were to think about the resonance contributors, we would have in one nitrogen that's going to be positively charged and one nitrogen that's going to be negatively charged. And that's true for both of these. So really this charge trying to put the positive and negative charges on the right atoms no longer applies in the case of the aminopyridine. What really matters most is that we find a form, the most important resonance contributor, that's this one here for the 2-aminopyridine, that's aromatic. And now in its neutral form, without any positive or negative charges, we draw that structure as aromatic. I think those are a little bit more details than what I really care that you understand, or really can totally, I think, analyze the structures just by the considerations that I've given you. But at least qualitatively, I hope I've tried to give you an idea that really what we try to do is consider the resonance contributors of the tautomeric forms, and then we do our best to match charges for the resonance contributors, the second best resonance contributors. And when we can do that, that's likely to be the tautomer that's most stable. Well, the story goes that in the nucleic acids, that the structure of the nucleic acids was actually not solved for over a year because Watson had proposed a structure that involved the wrong tautomeric form of an aminopyridine nucleic acid base. And we'll learn more about that when we come to our discussion of the nucleic acid building blocks.